It's arrived! The 2023 local SEO ranking factors are out. If you want to know how to get your business on top of Google Maps and Google Search this year, you'll definitely want to tune in for the next few minutes. Now, here is the thing. Google doesn't actually tell us these ranking factors themselves. But luckily, Darren Shaw, the president and founder of Whitespark, conducts an annual survey with input from 44 top local experts, including yours truly, to figure out the 149 most important local ranking factors. This year's survey is extra special because it also includes a list of things to avoid if you don't want your Google business profile suspended, plus tips on improving conversions and local service ads, and even how local pros are using artificial intelligence for SEO. It's basically the ultimate guide to local SEO, and I swear by it. I've put the link to it in the description below. Obviously, we can't go through everything in detail here, but I'll give you the rundown on the ranking factors that matter most if you want to show up in a local map pack and the key areas to focus on to dominate the local organic results. Sounds good? Let's dive in. Let's start off by looking at what affects your business visibility in the local pack the most. The primary category of your Google business profile is the number one ranking factor you need to consider. For some businesses, choosing a primary category is straightforward, like if you're a plumber, for example. But for others, such as lawyers or dentists, there can be several categories that could apply. It's important to choose wisely, as your primary category heavily influences your chances of showing up in the local pack. If you're unsure about which category to pick, a good idea is to check out your competitors. One way to do this is by downloading a Google Chrome extension called GMB Everywhere. I put the link to it in the description below. Once you have installed it, you can search for a keyword you want to rank for on Google Maps, and GMB Everywhere will highlight the primary and secondary categories that your competitors are using. The second most critical ranking factor to consider is the presence of keywords in your business name. If you have one or more keywords you want to rank for in your Google business profile name, it can significantly increase your visibility in the map pack. However, be careful not to add keywords to your business title just for the sake of ranking, as it goes against Google's guidelines. Instead, only add keywords that genuinely represent your business in the real world. For instance, suppose a clinic's primary services like this one are based on Chinese medicine, and this is clearly how they represent themselves in the real world based on their shopfront. In that case, they could add the keywords Chinese medicine to their business title. This would be perfectly acceptable and could significantly improve their local pack rankings. So according to the survey, the third most important thing when it comes to local rankings is how close your business is to the person doing the search. Basically, the closer you are, the higher you'll show up on the map pack. Unfortunately, there's not much you can do about this one, so let's move on to the next one. Next up is all about where your business is physically located. If someone does a search that includes the name of the city where your business is, or they're using a device that's based in that city, then you're more likely to show up in the local pack results. For example, if you're a divorce lawyer in Las Vegas, you're more likely to show up in a local pack if someone searches for divorce lawyer Las Vegas, or if they're using a computer or phone that's located in Las Vegas and they search for divorce lawyer. So if your business isn't located in the same city as the search, it's unlikely that you'll show up on the map pack. The solution? Move your business to where your target market is. Okay, I know that sounds pretty drastic, but it could be a really smart investment if your main customers are in a particular city. So the next big thing on the list is called
removal of spam listings through spam fighting.
Unfortunately, some shady business owners use spammy tactics like stuffing their business name with keywords, making multiple fake Google business profiles with fake addresses, and writing fake reviews to rank higher than honest businesses like you. But here is the deal. Fighting against these spammers has become a major strategy amongst local SEO experts. They even consider it as a separate local ranking factor because it directly affects the visibility of their clients' listings in the map pack, and you should care about it too. So if you think your competitors are being sneaky, then do something about it. Report their sketchy behavior to Google using the Google redressal form. I've dropped the link in the description for you. This will help level the playing field for everyone. But hey, here is a pro tip for you. Create a dummy Google account to use when submitting your reports. Not because your competitors will figure out who you are, because they won't, but because even the Google redressal form can be abused by the same shady businesses. And when Google sees too many reports from one account, they might start to question its legitimacy. So it's best to keep your real account out of it. Moving down our list, we have the high numerical Google rating factor. This one is simple. Listings with lower ratings, like a 3 out of 5, tend to rank lower in the map pack than those with higher ratings, like a 4 or 5. Plus, having good reviews on Google also helps improve customer perception of your business. So make sure your business gets glowing Google reviews by providing top-notch quality service. Up next, we have the additional Google Business Profile categories factor. While your primary category is crucial for your Google rankings in the map pack, adding extra categories can also make a difference. So don't forget to include them in your listing whenever possible. If you're not sure what categories to use, take a peek at your competitors' listings on Google Maps, just like we did when we looked at their primary category. If you've got GMB Everywhere downloaded, it will even show you which secondary categories they're using that you might want to consider using too. All right, we've made it to the last factor on the list I wanted to talk about, number of reviews. This one's pretty straightforward. Having more reviews on your Google listing can definitely boost your rankings in a map pack. But here is the catch. According to a recent study by Joy Hawkins at Sterling Sky, there seems to be a significant ranking boost once a listing hits 10 reviews. So it's important to aim for at least 10 reviews on your listing. However, getting even more reviews beyond that doesn't seem to have the same impact on your rankings. So while having a ton of reviews is great, it's not the only thing you should focus on. That being said, don't limit yourself to just 10 reviews. It's important to keep gathering more reviews to build trust and reputation to convert potential visitors into customers. So that's a wrap on the Google Map Pack ranking factors. I've covered 8 of them, which should keep you pretty occupied for now. But if you already got these covered, then feel free to check the remaining 141 at your leisure. In the meantime, let's take a look at the ranking factors that really matter if you want to come out on top in the local organic results. Coming in at number 1, we have the importance of having a dedicated page on your website for each service you provide. Unfortunately, many business owners make the mistake of thinking that a one-page website or bundling all their services onto one page is enough. This couldn't be further from the truth. By creating dedicated pages for each service you provide, you can target specific keywords for each service and rank locally for them separately. So don't be lazy and take the time to craft detailed pages for each service you provide. It will make a huge difference in your local organic rankings. At number 2, we have internal linking across entire website. In case you're not familiar with this concept, internal links are links that connect one page of your website to another. It's a basic yet highly effective SEO strategy that can significantly improve your rankings. By using internal links, you can signal to search engine crawlers like Google which pages on your website are the most important ones. Shockingly, in nearly all the websites I've analyzed, I've noticed a lack of internal links that can be quickly improved in just a few clicks. Identify your most important pages and ensure they're linked from other parts of your site to boost their rankings. Moving on, let's talk about quality/authority of inbound links to domain. This is basically about links from other websites that point to your website. And guess what? The more reputable these websites are, the better it is for you. And if those websites happen to be local, even better. So if you can get links from places like your local Chamber of Commerce website, newspaper, or even your local church, it will really boost your rankings in local search results. Okay, so the next factor we're going to discuss is geographic keyword relevance of domain content. This just means whether your website's content contains any location-based keywords. So let's say you're a divorce lawyer in Wichita and you want to rank higher for your location. To make sure your website is relevant, you must add the geo-targeted keyword Wichita into your website content and tags. You don't have to go crazy and add your location keywords too many times, but it's a good idea to at least have it in your page title and main header. This leads me to our next factor. keywords in Google Business Profile landing page title. When you create your Google Business Profile, it's a good idea to link it to a specific landing page on your website. In most cases, this landing page will be your homepage. Now, here's the thing. You have to make sure that the meta title of your landing page includes your primary target keywords. Going back to our divorce attorney example, you will see that the meta title of the page they link to from their Google Business Profile includes the primary target keywords along with their location. This shouldn't take you more than 2 minutes to update if you have to. Let's talk about the next factor. Quantity of inbound links to domain from locally relevant domains. Now, I kind of already touched on this when I went through the third ranking factor, quantity of inbound links to domain. The key here is to get as many links from other locally relevant websites as possible, even if the quality isn't top notch. For instance, getting a link from your local car mechanics website or your favorite cafe's website can still make a big difference. These links can help signal to Google that your website is relevant to the local community and boost your visibility in local search results. All right, let's talk about the next ranking factor, topical product or service keyword relevance across entire website. In local SEO, search engines use topical relevance to figure out how much of an expert you are in your industry. This is important because it helps them decide where to rank your website and its pages in search results. So if you're a dentist, you want to make sure your website covers all kinds of dental topics like teeth whitening, dental implants, gum treatments, Invisalign, and more. This way, search engines will see you as an authority in your field and rank you higher for dentist-related keywords. The last ranking factor I'm going to talk about ties in very well with this topical relevance and is called volume of quality content on service pages. So we already know that creating separate pages for your services is crucial for ranking well in local search results. But just having a bunch of pages isn't enough. You gotta make sure the content on those pages is top-notch if you want to snag those top spots. A measly paragraph and a few generic pics from free image stock websites won't do the trick. You have to step up your game. Consider adding cool stuff like custom images of your services, before and after pics of your work, case studies, customer reviews, videos, awards and recognitions, unique selling points, and more. That's what I call volume of quality. That was the last local organic ranking factor I wanted to talk about. If you can get these factors right, you'll definitely see an improvement in your local search rankings. And if you feel like you've already covered them all, no worries. Just work your way down the list because there are plenty more factors to keep you busy. Before I wrap up, I just wanted to remind you that this year's survey has some super cool sections about suspension ranking factors, negative ranking factors, and conversion factors. If you want to avoid wasting time on the wrong things and prevent your business from getting suspended, make sure to check those out too. That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Oh, and if you want to optimize your Google Business Profile faster, be sure to check out the next video. I'll catch you guys later. In the meantime, happy marketing.